Okay, students, so we started unit 2, right? So unit 2 consists of 3 topics: projection of points, projection of straight lines, projections of plane surfaces, right? So coming to first topic is projection of points, right? Now you know this concept, 4 quadrants concept. This is your horizontal plane, this is your vertical plane, right? So this is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. As we discussed already, when the object is placed in first quadrant, first angle of projection. When object is placed in second quadrant, second angle of projection. Similar manner, here we are going to talk about points, right? So when a point is placed in first quadrant, right, so how the location of point will be? The point is located above HP, in front of VP, right? Same concept. When the point is located in second quadrant, above HP, behind VP. When the point is located in third quadrant, below HP, behind VP. When the point is located in fourth quadrant, below HP, in front of VP, right? So you know this is the first angle projection, second angle of projection, third angle of projection, and fourth angle of projection. In first angle of projection, always above the reference line we are going to mark front view, below the reference line we are going to mark top view. In second angle of projection, above the reference line only we are going to mark front view and top view, below we are not going to mark anything. Right? And third angle projection is the reverse of first angle projection. In first angle, front view, top view, no? Here it will be top view and front view. Fourth angle projection, it is the reverse of second angle projection. Here front view and top view is marking in numerator, no? So here we are marking in denominator. Numerator, we are not marking anything. Right? So you know this concept already. But instead of object, we are talking about points here. Projection of point. Right? So now coming to conventions. Actually, what is this? Actual points is in capital letters, front view with small letters indicating with dash, top view indicates with small letters, and side view indicates with small letters with double dash. See, actual points, that means the distance between two points, right? That actual points indicates with capital letters. That means in questions they will mention the point name in capital letters, but whenever you are marking front view you have to indicate with small letters with dash, A dash, B dash, C dash, so on. Top view without dash, but you have to indicate with small letters only, A, B, C, so on. Side view indicates with small letters, right? Double dash, A double dash, B double dash, C double dash, so on. See, this is very important, how to mark the points. Front view with single dash, side view with double dash, top view without dash, right? So this is the concept of projection of points. So let us see the questions. Right? So question number 1. Let us read the question. Point A. Name of the point is A, indicating in capital letters. Point A is 30 mm above HP and 45 mm in front of VP. 30 mm above HP, 45 mm in front of VP. Draw its projections. Right? So draw its projections means you have to indicate front view and top view. You have to mark front view and top view, right? So let us see how to solve this one. First, draw a reference line of any length, right? You are marking the reference line, no? Mark the midpoint for that line. Now this is your reference plane. I am naming it as XY, right? Always this will be your vertical plane, this will be your horizontal plane, right? Vertical plane and horizontal plane. Now, coming to question. The question is, name of the point is A. Name of the point is A. Right? That point A is above HP, in front of VP. If you observe carefully, above HP in front of VP means you have to locate the point in first quadrant. In first quadrant, above the reference line, you are going to mark front view. Below the reference line, top view. So above the reference line, you have to mark front view. Below the reference line, you have to mark top view. Right? So if you are not understanding this concept, or if you feel this is hard concept, that means which one is first quadrant, second quadrant, third, fourth. In first quadrant, above HP, in front of VP. Second quadrant, above HP, behind VP. Third quadrant, below HP, behind VP. Fourth quadrant, below HP, in front of VP. If it is very hard to remember this concept, if you feel this is hard to remember the concept, now the simple way is, draw the reference line, mark the midpoint. Always this is your vertical plane, this is your horizontal plane. Right? But all the problems, above the reference line, vertical plane. Below the reference line, horizontal plane. VP and HP. Now, point A is 30 mm above HP. Now you see, this is completely HP. This is completely horizontal plane. We should mark the point above the horizontal plane. That means, I should mark the point here. Above the horizontal plane, I should mark the here point here. Distance is how much? 30 mm. So, I will take 30 mm distance, right? And I will mark the point here. Right? Now, 45 mm in front of VP. Right? This is completely VP. Right, in front of VP. In front of VP means this is VP. You have to mark the point in front of it. Right, so distance is 45. Take 45 distance. Right, from that midpoint, draw a line of 45 distance. Right, now mark the point here. Right, now you see 30 mm above HP. I am marking the point here. No, right, so first mark the dimensions. 30 mm above HP. This is 30 mm distance. Right? Straight line. Straight line. This is to 45 mm distance. Right? Now, how to name the points? 30 mm above HP. Right? Actually, in first quadrant above, you are marking front view. Front view means I have to indicate with dash. Right? So, I have to indicate with here small letter A dash. Right? Above the reference line, front view. Below the reference line, top view. Top view indicates without dash. A. Right, so this A dash is to a front view. Take height 5 mm, write down front view, write down full form front view and top view. Write down the full form top view, front view and top view. Right, 30 above HP in front of VP. Above HP in front of VP is first quadrant. In first quadrant, the condition is above the reference line, you have to mark front view. Below the reference line, you have to mark top view. Right? Above the reference line, I am marking front view. Below the reference line, I am marking top view. Right? If it is very difficult to understand this concept, do one thing. Now here HP is there. 30 mm distance HP. 30 mm distance HP. Wherever HP is there, right, simply write down as front view. Simply write it as front view. You remember this point. Wherever in question, if HP is there, that distance is front view. HP is front view. Right? So 30 mm distance front view, no, front view indicates with dash. So this is the problem. Right? So let us see next one. point B is lying on HP and 55 mm in front of VP. Draw its projections. What is the condition? Lying on HP, 55 mm in front of VP. Right? Now you see how to solve this one. Same process. First, draw a reference line. Draw a reference line of any length. Mark the midpoint for that. Right? Name it as X and Y. Right? Vertical plane and horizontal plane. Always that is vertical plane, horizontal plane. Right? Now you see, first point B, lying on HP. Whenever the condition is lying on HP, lying on VP. Right? So if it is lying on HP or lying on VP, you have to mark the point on the reference line. Right? So HP is there, no? It is here, front view, B dash. Simply HP, front view, write down HP, front view, dash. 55 mm in front of VP. This completely, this portion is VP, no? In front of VP means I have to draw here. Right? So distance is 55. I have to mark the distance 55. Right? And mark the point here. This distance is B. Right? So mark the dimensions. From B, draw the extension line. Right? So distance is here 55 mm. Right? So dash is there, no? Take height 5 mm. Write down this is to a front view. Right? Without dash, this is to a top view. Right? Now you see here, only the point should be dark, because in output they ask to mark the projections of points. So that's why I am marking only the point in dark manner. Remaining total problem, it should be in very light manner. Only the points should be dark. Right? So let us see the next question. Point C is lying on VP and 55 mm above HP. Draw its projections. Right? So first, same concept. Draw the reference line of any length. Draw the reference line of any length. Name it as XY, vertical plane above, horizontal plane below. Write down this one, vertical plane and horizontal plane. Right? Now after that, point name is C. It is lying on VP. Lying on HP, lying on VP means you have to mark the point on the reference line. Right? VP, no? So simply name it as, this point is here, C. Then next, 55 mm above HP. This is completely HP, no? Above HP means I should mark the point here. Right? So distance is 55. Mark the distance 55. Right? Name the point. Point name is HP, no? HP means C dash, front view. Right? Wherever in question if they mention HP, write down front view. VP, top view. Right? Just simply I am saying, if you are difficult to remember this concept, first, second, third, fourth, similarly HP means front view, VP means top view. Remember this one. Right? After that, mark the dimensions. From C, draw the extension line. Closed and filled arrow marks. Closed and filled arrow marks. Right? Write down here 55 mm. Right? So C dash, no, this is to a front view. C, no, this is to a top view. Right? Take height 5 mm. Take height 5 mm. Okay, actually you have to solve the problems based on this concept. You have to check the question. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. You have to check whether in which quadrant the point was lying. If it is lying in third quadrant, above the reference line you should mark top view. Below the reference line you should mark front view. Right? So if you are very difficult to remember that concept, simply HP front view, VP top view. Right? Let us see the next question. Draw the projections of point D, which lies on both HP and VP. point D is lying on both HP and VP. Right? So how to draw this one first? Draw the reference line of any length. Name it as XY, VP, HP. Right? So lying on both HP and VP means you have to mark the point on the reference line. Right? So D dash, comma D. Front view, comma top view. The point is lying on both HP and VP. Right? Then next, coming to next question. Point E is lying on 45 mm above HP, 60 mm behind VP. See, above HP, behind VP. Above HP, behind VP means the point is lying in second quadrant. Right? If the point is lying in the second quadrant, above the reference line, you should mark both front view and top view. Right? So let us see how to solve this one. First, draw the reference line of any length. Right? Then next, mark the midpoint of that line. Name it as here X, Y. Always this is vertical plane, this is your horizontal plane. Coming to the question, name of the point is E, lying on 45 mm above HP. This is completely HP. Above HP means I have to mark the point. Distance is 45. So distance is 45. I have to draw a line. Right? So this is the point name. E no HP. HP means I am writing it as here E dash. Right? So dash no. So front view. Then next, 60 mm behind VP. See, this is completely VP. Right? So behind means back side you have to mark the point. Right? So back side means you have to mark the point here only. If you are marking the point here, it will come in front of VP. Right? So behind VP means in the VP only you have to mark the point. Right? So anyway, I have marked 45 now. So remaining 15 I will extend here only. Remaining 15 I will extend. I will mark the point and name it as E. This is to a top view. Or I can draw separately also. I can draw 45 here and next I can draw 60 here. Separately also I can draw. Right? Now coming to dimensions. Mark the dimensions properly. This distance is 60 mm, right, and this distance is 45 mm, 45 mm, right, see, above HP, behind VP, right. See, this is the concept. Above HP, behind VP, second quadrant. In second quadrant, above the reference line, we are going to mark front view and top view. Below, we are not going to mark anything. See, this is the reference line. Above the reference line only, we are marking front view and top view. Below the reference line, we are not marking anything. Right? Let us see the next question. Point F is lying on 35 mm below HP and 25 mm behind VP. Draw its projections. Right? 35 mm below HP, 25 mm behind VP. Below HP, behind VP. Below HP, behind VP means third quadrant. In third quadrant, above the reference line, top view. Below the reference line, front view. See, below HP, behind VP. Above, top view. Below, front view. Right? So same we are drawing here. How to construct this one? Same process. First draw the reference line. Draw the reference line of any length. Mark the midpoint. Right? Name it as XY, VP and HP. 35 mm below HP. This is completely HP. Below means HP. Below only you have to mark the point. Right? So I have to mark the point here only. If I mark here, it is above HP. So I should mark the point here only, below HP. Distance is 35. So take 35 distance, right? Mark the point. Here the point name is F. HP no, so writing as F dash, right? F dash is to a front view. Dash no, so dash indicates front view. 25 mm behind VP. Behind VP means back side of VP. So in VP only we have to mark the point. Distance is how much here? 25, right? Mark the point. Name this point as F, right? This is to a top view. Take height 5 mm and write down top view. How to mark dimensions? Draw the extension line, right? Draw the dimensional line. Closed and filled arrow marks here. Closed and filled arrow marks. Right? This distance is here 35 mm. And this, sorry, this is 25, no? Right. 25 mm behind VP. This is 25 mm and this is here 35 mm, right? 35 mm below HP, 25 mm behind VP. Below HP, behind VP, third quadrant above the reference line top view, below the reference line front view, top view and front view. You can check either like this or HP, simply write down front view. HP, simply write down front view, and front view indicates with dash. Right, after that see the next question. Point G is 45 mm below HP and 60 mm in front of VP. Draw its projections. Below HP, in front of VP. It is fourth quadrant. In fourth quadrant, above the reference line, we are not going to mark anything. Below the reference line only, we are marking front view and top view. See, below HP, in front of VP, fourth quadrant. This is the condition, right? So let us see how to solve this one. Draw the reference line of any length, mark the midpoint, right? Name it as XY, reference line, vertical plane and horizontal plane. 45 mm below HP. This is completely HP, no? Below HP means in HP only we have to mark the point. Distance is here 45, so I'm drawing the 45 mm line, right? Marking the point. Name of the point is G. So I am writing here G, HP no, indicating with dash. So G dash is to a front view. 60 mm in front of VP. This is completely VP. In front of VP means I have to mark the point here in front of VP. Right? So anyway I have marked 45 no, remaining 15 I am extending here. Right? Mark the point. Name this point as G, right? This is to a top view, right? Mark the dimensions properly. Draw the dimensional line. Draw the extension line. This is 45 mm, right? And then next, this point is 60 mm, right? So these are the problems in projections of points. See, only first thing is the point should be dark. First thing is point should be dark, right? And the next thing is read the question. If you know the concept, follow this concept. In question, if they mention below HP, behind VP. Below HP, behind VP is third quadrant. If you know this, third quadrant, in third quadrant, above top view, below front view. You can draw like this or simply follow this one. Above HP, in front of VP. Below HP, behind VP. Right? So HP, wherever HP was there, simply mark it as front view. Right? So let us see the last problem. Right? Till now, we have solved the problems separately. That means, separately we have marked the point A, B, C, D. Separately, we have drawn all the problems. But coming to last problem, in one diagram only, we are going to mark all these points from A to I. In one diagram only, we are going to mark all these points, right? See here, mark the projections of the following points on a common reference line. In one single reference line, you have to mark all these points, keeping the projectors 15 mm apart. Keeping the projectors 15 mm apart means from point A to point B 15, point B to point C 15, point C to point D 15, like that. Right, so let us see how to solve this problem. Right, so first of all, what you have to do means draw the reference line of any length first. Draw the reference line of any length. Right, now I am starting the diagram from here. Right, first right, so I'm starting the diagram from here. Right, so from this point I will leave 15 mm gap. I will mark the point. Right, this is for A point. Again from A to B I have to mark the point. Now again I will mark 15 mm. B to C 15 mm. Right, C to D 15, D to E 15, E to F 15, F to G 15, G to H 15, H to I 15. Right, first we are drawing this line. No, first we have to mark the reference line. Right, and this is starting point. Right, from starting point to A point 15 mm distance, from A to B 15, B to C 15, C to D 15. Right, name it as this is your XY vertical plane and horizontal plane. Now start the diagram. Point A 25 mm above HP. This is completely HP. Above HP means I have to mark the point here. Right, so distance is how much? 25. Right, so how many points we have to mark here? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Right, now 25 mm above HP. I am taking 25 mm distance, so above HP I have to mark the point. So HP, no, naming it as here A dash. Right, I am writing here front view. Right, after that 35 mm in front of VP, 35 mm in front of VP. This is completely VP. No, in front of VP means I should mark here below. Right, so take the distance 35, take the distance 35, mark the point, name it as this point is A. Write down this is your top view. Point A is completed. Then next B. B is 25 mm above HP. Right. So take the distance 25. Right. Mark the point. Name it as HP. No, HP means front view. No. So name it as B dash. Right. So B dash is nothing but your front view.